Sometimes in Airtable, you might want to create a folder inside of your Google Drive, but for more advanced cases, you might have subfolders that could change depending on what you have linked to that data. In this tutorial, I'm showcasing a slightly more advanced automation that's going to help you build automatic folders in your Google Drive, but keep them correctly nested under the projects or whatever hierarchy you need for your Drive folders. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we make it our mission to help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools and automation. Now, if that sounds too good to be true, chances are you haven't started leveraging the power of automation yet. In order to get you started, I've built a free webinar training that will get you up to speed with the fundamentals in automation so that you can start reclaiming your time and stop wasting it on those mundane, repetitive tasks. If that sounds even a little bit interesting, check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, where you can sign up and get that information automatically sent to you. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this. We're talking about a slightly more advanced automation here. Now, I want to warn you before we kick into this, if this is the first automation you've ever built, hit pause. Start with something easier because we're going to be going into some pretty detailed logic here with a lot of pathing and a relatively complex setup. So I would strongly advise not starting here, but if you're on the more intermediate to advanced side, let's hop into this automation. I'm going to break it all down for you. But before we kick into that automation, we've got to start with our data structure. Now, here's the scenario I'm imagining. We have projects in our database that we track and they link to tasks. So a task is done on behalf of a project, or is it? Well, if we flip into tasks and take a look, we can see that maybe we don't always connect to a project. Maybe a task is kind of a miscellaneous task. It doesn't belong to a specific project. And so for this case, we don't want to create this task folder inside of the project folder. Instead, for this scenario where we don't have a project pertaining to a task, we would want this task to just show up in a miscellaneous folder. So let's flip now into Google Drive and take a look at how this could be set up. I have a folder here. First of all, my parent folder is called subfolder example. That is going to be the parent folder for everything that we're doing for this particular tutorial. Now inside of here, I have my project folders as well. So here's project one, here's project two, but I also have this folder that's kind of sitting out that's not assigned for a project, and instead it's just collecting miscellaneous tasks. Any task that doesn't belong to a specific project would be filed away here. But then we're going to, inside of these folders, be able to click into them and see the tasks inside of the folder. So you can check this out here at the top. As we go a layer deeper, we're gonna see an additional folder. So again, here's my drive. Here is my subfolder example folder. Again, that's for everything in this particular example. Now I'm in project one, and then I have a folder for task one as well. I can go back out to the subfolder example, drill into project two, and here's task two, back to the subfolder example, into miscellaneous tasks, and I've got a couple of tasks here that I've created with my automation. So how do we know where we want to create this folder? How do we know what the parent folder relationship is? That all comes down to the advanced logic that we build inside of our automation. So let's turn around and pop on into Make, and I'll walk you through this step by step. Now, the first part of this is we are using a hook here, a webhook. And our webhook is simply a URL, and we are going to pass along some extra parameters to this URL, which is going to, when pushed, trigger the automation, but also give us information about the particular folder that we're going to be creating. So let's flip back into Airtable really quickly and look at how we build that webhook. Inside of my projects table, I have the create folder button. There's a lot of logic that's going on into this, and you can break down this formula if you'd like. Essentially, what I'm saying is if the Google Drive folder, that is this URL right here, if this exists, and if the Google Drive folder ID, that's just a random string, which we'll get to in a minute, if both of these things already exist, then I don't want to be able to push this button. Why? Why would I create a folder with an automation if the folder already exists? The answer is, I don't want to do that. So that's why I've built that into my formula here. If these variables already exist, I cannot create the folder again. And you see right here that I can't push this button because of the fact that I already have a Google folder and I already have a Google folder ID. So that's the first part of this formula. Now we're going to get into the webhook part. And that is everything that happens after that little bit of logic. Here we're saying concatenate, and then we're bringing in right here the webhook. This is going to, again, trigger that automation. But to trigger the automation without additional information doesn't do us much good. So this is where we pass on our first parameter. Question mark record underscore ID equals record underscore ID is the name that I've assigned to this variable, which is the record ID. And now I plug in the record ID. This is a unique ID inside of Airtable. After that, I then include this additional parameter and table equals. And in this case, you'll notice that I'm in my projects table. So I'm passing along the table parameter of projects. So I'm passing two variables here. What table am I in? And also, what's the record ID? That's the short version of the information that I'm giving the webhook. Now, if I look in my tasks table, you'll see the exact same webhook was used here in my create folder. Of course, I've got a bit more logic here, which I'll get into. But the key takeaway here is here, my table is tasks. So when someone pushes the button to create a folder from my tasks table, I'm passing that variable along to make. So make already knows that by the time the automation starts running, that it needs to look for this record in the tasks table. From the other side, if it's pushed in the projects table, make knows that the record belongs in the projects table as well. Before we flip back into make, I do want to break down the additional logic here. If the projects exists and the parent folder ID is blank, meaning that I've linked a task to a project, but I don't have a parent folder ID, as in the case right here of project 3, I don't want to be able to push this button because I need this parent folder ID. And in this case, project 3 doesn't yet have its own folder inside of Google Drive. And so I can't create my task inside of the project 3 folder if it doesn't yet exist. So that's why I have a bit of additional logic here. And then the other part of this logic is the same as what we saw on the projects table, which, just to reiterate, is saying, hey, if I already have a Google Drive folder link and a folder ID, then I don't want to push the button again and create another folder. So pretty straightforward. Let's go ahead and get into the next part of the automation now. Flipping back into make, I've included a router. And what we're going to do here is take one path or the other because I have applied filters on these different paths. So here I have my tasks path. If the parameter that I passed along here from the table, remember we named this variable table equals, it's either going to be equal to tasks or projects. Well, if it's tasks, then I'm going to take this top path. If it's projects, then yes, I'm going to take this bottom path. So let's look at the projects path first. Given that it's a little bit more simple because it is the parent in the hierarchy between projects and tasks. So first things first, we're going to find this record using its record ID. The record ID is passed along in the webhook. Remember, two variables were passed, the record ID and the table. And so I'm going to look for the record. Now, of course, on this path, I know we're in the projects table. And so I'm telling it, look in the projects table because you wouldn't have passed this filter if you weren't in the projects table, and find the record ID based on the record ID that we got in the webhook. Pretty straightforward on this end. Now for the Google Drive creation, I want you to create a new folder in Google Drive. The folder location is going to be in the subfolder example here. Now we can get this just by clicking in here, and you see the spinning wheel, and you can select from your different folders. So I'll select subfolder example. What name do we want to give the folder? In this case, I'll take the name of the record, which is project 1 or whatever project we're looking at. So that's it for creating the drive. Now the last piece is to go back into Airtable with that information. What am I doing? Well, I want to update this record that we are working on here. I've just created a folder for it in Google Drive. But creating the folder in and of itself isn't enough. I need to tell Airtable about the folder I just created. And so what I'm doing is updating that record, and I want to bring in the WebView link and put that in the Google Drive folder. This will allow anybody in my database to just click on that link and immediately open up that folder so they don't have to go hunting for it inside of Google Drive. Very cool feature. Number two, I also want to pass along the folder ID. And this is going to be very important for filling out the next part of the automation where we're building the folder inside of this project folder. So bring along that folder ID, put that back into Airtable as well. Let's now flip back into Airtable to take a look at what that looks like. Remember, we are on the project path here. And so here I have project 3 that doesn't yet have a Google Drive folder link, nor does it have a Google Drive folder ID. So let's create it. Make sure your automation is turned on and saved, and then you should be able to hit that button to create that folder. It's gonna open up your webhook, and if we flip back into Airtable, just in time, we will see that a new folder was created in Google Drive, the link was shared back to Airtable, and we've also received that Google Drive folder ID. Now I can click this link, or if you wanna get fancy, you can create a button like I've done here, which simply looks at that URL, because let's face it, clicking a button is way cooler than clicking on a link. And so I can now click this button here. It's gonna open the folder. Remember, this was for project 3. So we see that that folder was properly created inside of our subfolder example, and we now have a new folder inside of that called project 3. If I go back to the high level and look at subfolder example, we now have 4 folders where we previously only showed 3. This part is pretty straightforward, but now we have to jump into the next level where we're going to build the subfolders that come from the tasks table. So this is now on the tasks path inside of Make. So once we're in here, now we're gonna get that record in Airtable. So we're gonna look for it in our tasks table. Now there are 2 different possibilities here. Let's flip back into Airtable and look at our tasks table. Possibility number 1 is that we have a task that belongs to a project, in which case we want to build a new folder inside of the projects folder, nicely nested inside for this particular task. But there's also the possibility that the task is a miscellaneous task that doesn't belong to a project. So in this case, we wouldn't have it linked to a project, and we would want instead to create this task folder inside of our miscellaneous tasks folder. So for this, we're going to need 2 more paths inside of Make. Flipping back now into Make, we have yet another router. Now this router only applies to our tasks path here, and you can see that we either have a project subfolder or we don't. And so these filters are pretty straightforward. There is either a parent folder ID, that is to say a parent folder exists, or otherwise. We don't even need to fill out this condition because we can say that this is the fallback route. That means if this particular route fails to run, then this one will run. The end. So now what do we do? Well, inside of the first of these paths, that is, there is a project that exists, we need to set up the Google Drive. And here's where things get a little fuzzy. So what I would suggest you do here is first get the ID information of your particular folder. Now, the best and easiest way to do this, if you're starting from scratch, just delete all of this, and you're setting up this folder location, let's imagine, for the first time. I would suggest turning off your map here and clicking to choose your folder. In this particular case, I'm gonna choose my subfolder example because that's my top level folder for this setup. Now, before moving on, we can click map back on. And what we're gonna see is that that subfolder example was now converted into its ID. This string right here is the parent folder ID for the folder called subfolder example. Now, if I wanna build another folder inside of this, I can separate that by putting a slash, and I need to again know the folder ID for this. Well, it just so happens that I have the folder ID for this. It lives inside of my task in this field right here. This is my parent folder ID. So at the end of the day, what this is gonna look like is a long string. The first ID is this folder, the subfolder example ID. The next ID is going to be the folder ID for that particular project. So flipping back into Make, your setup should look something like this. Again, remember, this particular piece is gonna be constant for your project, whatever that big mega folder is that you're doing all of this filing under. And then under that, when you get into the subfolder, you have your parent folder ID below that. Again, separate that with a slash, and you're good to go. Now, our last step is going to be just as it was before, to go back into Airtable and update the record with the Google Drive folder link and the Google Drive folder ID. But we're not quite done. One final path for us is this last path where we know that it's supposed to go to our miscellaneous tasks. So because this is not changing every single time, I don't have to include any of those parent folder IDs. If you're setting this up yourself for the first time, it's pretty simple to do. Simply select the folder, bring in our case, subfolder example. And now we're gonna see all the different folders inside of there. And we want the one called miscellaneous tasks. If it ever loads, here it is. Make that selection, click okay, save up your automation, and you're good to go. Now let's flip back to Airtable, take this out for a couple spins, and make sure that everything's working as planned. So here I want to create a new folder for task 3. It lives inside of project 3. Before I do that, let's flip first into my Google Drive. You see I'm in subfolder example. Inside of that, I'm looking inside of my project 3 folder, and I have nothing in here. So I want to create a new folder inside of this folder. Let's flip back to Airtable and push the button. The webhook opens up, we can close our webhook down. We see that the automation ran as planned, but instead of pushing this button, let's instead go back to our project 3. So here I am inside of the folder in Google Drive, project 3, and now you see I have a new folder inside of this folder. Or the more convenient route, flip back to Airtable, click on the open folder button. It's gonna open up right into that folder inside of my Google Drive, and we'll have the proper nesting of folders here once it loads. The only other part to test, flipping back into Airtable, would be any task that's not assigned to a project. Here I have task 5. Imagine this is a miscellaneous task not assigned to a particular project. I click create folder. Again, I open up that webhook, my automation triggers, and now I open up this folder, which should be nested inside of my miscellaneous tasks folder. So there it is, subfolder example, miscellaneous tasks, task number 5. I know that this is a lot because there are 3 different possibilities in this automation, a lot of complex pathing and logic. I hope that you can take this step by step and build this out for yourself. Let me know what questions you have below, and be sure to subscribe to this channel if you want to stay on top of no-code news and no-code automation. That's a wrap for this. I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.